rainbow.
Anglers travel from across the state and around the country to fish in Arkansas's tailwater trout streams. But good trout fishing may not be as far away as you think. For the past decade, the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission has been opening the world of trout fishing to residents of Arkansas's more urban areas.
The Family Community Fishing Program started out by stocking catfish, but we quickly realized that in the winter months we'd like to provide opportunity, and rainbow trout was the obvious choice there, and we stock them in 22 different locations around the state.
November through February, the Game and Fish Commission's Family and Community Fishing Program stocks about 75,000 rainbow trout in small community fishing ponds across much of Arkansas.
Trout are able to survive in temperatures they prefer, about 55 degrees Fahrenheit, but can survive all the way up into the mid-70s. And so these ponds throughout most of Arkansas, at least the northern two-thirds of Arkansas, provide those kind of temperatures throughout the entire winter months.
The urban trout stockings provide a seasonal fishery, but there's much more than a season's worth of time and effort that goes into creating this unique fishing opportunity.
They don't just show up by magic. There's a lot of folks behind the scenes putting a lot of time and effort into getting these trout to the public.
The process starts at the Game and Fish Commission's Jim Hinkle Spring River State Fish Hatchery near Mammoth Spring. The hatchery receives trout eggs from federal hatcheries in Tennessee and Montana, as well as fingerling trout from federal hatcheries at Norfolk and Greers Ferry. It produces about a million catchable trout each year.
And they're going to grow the fish out again for about 15 months to get up to a 12-inch catchable rainbow trout. It's a lot of work. These things don't just happen overnight.
Eggs tumble for a week to 10 days before hatching.
Those eggs will hatch. You have what's called a yolk sac fry. Those are going to tumble into a small aquarium. They'll stay there for a few days and then go into larger round aquariums indoors and grow to several inches, what's known as a fingerling fish.
The trout then move outside to large tanks and raceways, where they'll spend more than a year until reaching the stocking size of 11 inches.
A lot of people probably don't take the time to think, you know, what all's gone into this fish.
And the journey is only beginning. Batten and his colleagues in the Family and Community Fishing Program put in long hours to get the fish from the hatchery to the public.
We're about to launch over to Lone Oak to get a fish truck on what's to be a long journey to bring trout back to the good folks of Central Arkansas.
First stop is the Joe Hogan State Fish Hatchery to pick up a specialized fish hauling truck.
All right, it's 7:30 in the morning. We're finally on the road. We had a little miscommunication about getting the truck on time, and we're about to make the long haul up to Mammoth Springs, grab some trout.
150 miles and three bone-jarring hours later, it's time to take on a load of rainbow trout. Filling the truck with water from the hatchery reduces stress on the fish because they're adapted to its temperature and chemical makeup. Once the truck is filled with water, the fish go for an unusual ride from the hatchery's concrete raceways to the truck's holding tanks.
They're going to be crowded in a raceway, a concrete raceway, and then be pumped up through a really interesting tube system where you're pumping trout and water through this tube system. The water falls out and the trout end up going through this tube and into the trucks.
Loaded up with more than 5 tons of fish and water, it's time to head back south.
We are loaded down with 2,000 trout from the Jim Hinkle Mammoth Springs Trout Hatchery, and we're headed down to Central Arkansas to drop them off at some community ponds.
Fish trucks don't provide the smoothest highway driving experience, but loaded with fish and water, the return trip doesn't shake you up quite as bad as the northbound portion with an empty payload. More than 9 hours and 300 miles after starting the day, it's finally time to drop some trout.
The Family and Community Fishing Program is really excited to give the opportunity to folks that live in urban areas a chance to go catch trout. You know, a lot of Arkansans know about the major tailwater trout fisheries, the White River, Greers Ferry, Little Red River, Little Missouri. But we wanted to give a seasonal opportunity to folks that might not make the trek up to one of these tailwaters a chance to catch a trout in Arkansas, such a popular game fish.
Fishermen often wonder what happens to the trout when water temperatures rise in the spring.
About April or May, depending on where you're at, we're going to hit temperatures that are going to be too warm for those trout to survive. However, we found that most of these trout are getting utilized, they're getting caught, and in my 5 years with the program, I've yet to get a call saying, oh, we've got 100 dead fish or anything like that. So really the vast majority are being caught and taken out.
By tagging some of the trout, Game and Fish can track how many are being caught. Anglers who catch tagged fish also can win prizes through the Family and Community Fishing Program.
It's fun, it's prizes, folks get an opportunity to try for a prize, and that brings more people out to the pond, which is what we want in the end. More people fishing is the whole goal of this program. But also it allows me to track about what percentage of these tags are being returned. Gives me an idea of how many of the fish are being caught. And overall, the returns are very impressive.
It's a long journey from a trout egg to a catchable size fish in your local city park pond. But the reward of more people fishing is worth the effort.
What this program provides is an opportunity for folks to fish that maybe don't own a boat, aren't going to go to the lake, aren't going to go to a tailwater, but they have pleasant memories of fishing or just heard about it and want to get into it. We're trying to give them a place within stone's throw of your urban centers to give them a shot to go fishing, buy a license, be part of the Game and Fish family.